Hello friends, welcome to my channel Tutel. Today we are going to discuss few numericals related to second law of motion. Now in our previous class we have discussed the relation that is P equals MV. Let's discuss a few examples related to the same. For example, if a cricket person is catching a ball, okay, what happens? Now the ball is coming from this direction and when he catches it, the person, the baller, he moves his hand back like this. Why do you think he pulls his hand backwards? He does this because we have already studied that force is equal to the rate of the change of momentum. So I can say delta momentum, delta would represent the change, delta momentum divided by time. Yes, this is my equation for the second law. Now, when the person pulls his hand backwards, in the backward direction, he increases the time. Now, since force is inversely proportional to time, so as the time period increases, the force decreases. That is the reason why he will not get hurt. Now, just imagine a person standing there and he catches the ball like this. When he catches the ball like this, a lot of force would be applied on his hands and that is the reason why he might get hurt, right? So, as the time period increases, the force applied on his hand, it also decreases. Next example I can think of is, you must have seen the karate player. What he does is, he swiftly moves his hand and he breaks the tie. Now what does he do there? What he does is, he quickly he is doing it. So in that process, he is decreasing the time period. As much time is reduced in the process, the force is increased by that much times, since they are inversely proportional, and hence a large force is applied and the person is able to break the tie. This relation is very useful, very very useful. It is also useful when, for example, you are sitting in a car and you have your seatbelt on. What do you think the seatbelt does? Now when the person in front, he applies a brake, so obviously you tend to move forward. Now when you are tending to move forward, the seatbelt, it stops you from going forward or it reduces the time. Now as the time period increases, since force is inversely proportional to time, so force will decrease and hence much less force is applied on you. Now in this type of question, these type of questions are basically explanation or give reasons why. So it might come for 2 marks and for 1 mark. Now the division for the 2 mark is, you have to be very, very, very careful while answering these type of questions. So 1 mark is dedicated for the relation. Now in the case of the seat belt, the relation is between force and time, right? So you first need to specify, since force is inversely proportional to time, so in this case, as a time period, it increases, so the force decreases. So now when you said that force is inversely proportional to the time, you got 1 mark. And when you say that as the time increases, the force, it decreases, so for this you will get another 1 mark. That is the distribution for the marks. This is the marks scheme that is being followed. Now my first question says, what is the acceleration produced by a force of 12 newton exerted on an object of mass 3 kg? Try one thing, while I'm solving it along with me, you also solve it. This will be beneficial for you. Now what is the acceleration produced by a force of 12 newton? So the force that I have is 12 newton. So the force of 12 newton is acting on an object of mass 3 kg, right? And the person is asking, what is the acceleration produced? So I need to find the acceleration. Now according to second law of motion, according to Newton's second law, force is equal to mass into acceleration. Remember one formula that will help you solve. Now I need to find A, I have F, I have M. So from this I'll find A. Now A, if you forget how to find A, it's very simple. You do divide by 1 and you bring this M down. Simple crisscross and you bring this 1 up. So F times 1 is F and divided by M. Now what is the value of F that I have? It's 12. What is the value of M that I have? 3. So the answer will be 4. And what is the, this is my force, acceleration, I'm sorry. This is my acceleration and the unit of acceleration is 4 meter per second square. Never forget the units. It's very, very important that you take care of the units. If you forget this, you will lose your marks. This is my first question. The second question says, what force would be needed to produce an acceleration of 4 meter per second square on a ball of mass 6 kg. Now it says that the acceleration is of 4 meter per second square and the ball of mass 6 kg. The question is asking what force? So force is question mark. Simple, use the equation. According to Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. Now I need to find force, so is equal to mass is 6 times acceleration is 4, so I will get 24 and the unit of force is Newton. Simple, it's very easy to solve numericals in physics. If you first write down what all you have, then write what you do not know, and then write the formula that you know. It's very, very basic. Okay, let's try the next question. A force of 5 Newton, now the force that is acting is 5 Newton. So this force gives a mass m1. So there is a mass m1, and for this mass, the a1, a force of 5 Newton gives a mass m1 an acceleration of 8 meter per second square, and a mass m2 an acceleration of 24 meter per second square. What acceleration would give if both the masses are tied together? Now it's asking what is the acceleration if both the masses are tied together. So for this case, m would be m1 plus m2. Now see, I know the equation F is equal to ma, right? First, for this I need to find a. So I'll use this formula, but this a is applied to capital M. For capital M, what I need to find is m1 and m2. So m1, m2 I need to find. For M1, I have F and A1. I can find M1 by using the relation this one. Similarly, I can find M2 by using this relation as I have F and A2. Let's first find M1. Now, M is F by A. So, M1 is forces fixed for all the cases. F A1, which is equal to forces 5 divided by A1 is 8. And since it's mass, it will be kg. Similarly, M2 is F, that is 5. Divided by A2, that is 24, and this is kg. I have M1 and M2. Now I need to find this A, and I am using capital M. Capital M is M1 plus M2. So what I need to do is I need to find M, and that is M1 plus M2. What is M1? M1 is 5 by 8 plus this is 5 by 24. Do not divide it, simply calculate. 24 LCM, 8 3s are 15, plus 24 1s are 15, which 5, which will give me 20 by 24. Do not divide this because we are yet to do the calculation. Now put the equation here. F is given as 5, I need to calculate A. So A will be F divided by M. F is how much? 5 divided by capital M is 20. Now see, it's a very simple trick that you do, 20 by 24, right? So this 5 can be written as 5 by 1, right? In denominator, I will have 1. So multiplying it, I will multiply the extreme terms and the inward terms, right? Correct? So I will get this as 5 times 24 divided by 20. 5 4s are 4 6s are. So I will get the answer is 6. And since it's acceleration, so the answer will be 6 meter per second square. I hope this is clear to you. If you have any doubt, you can let me know. I'll explain it to you in a much better way in the comment section. Now let's continue to the next question. Now the next question says, calculate the force required to impart a car a velocity of 30 meter per second in 10 seconds. The mass of the car is 1500 kg. Now since it says that the velocity is 30 meter per second and u will be obviously 0 meter per second, the time it says is 10 seconds and the mass of the car is 1500 kg. Now if you remember, we did one more question, equation, that is mv minus u by t. Yes? Or you can find F equals ma, you can use that, and you can find A using this. So A would be V minus U, that is 30 minus 0 divided by 10, or you can put the terms here and then solve it. So by using this, I will get acceleration as 3. By using the formula F equals ma, my m is this multiplied by this, I will get answer as 4500 Newton. Let's solve it using this. Now mass, I'll just put the values. 1500 bracket V is 30 minus 0 divided by time is 10, So I'll subtract this like this, cancel them out. 150 bracket 30 minus 0 is 30. So 15 threes are 4500 newton. See, the answer will be same in both the cases, and both the formulas are same. It's just how you deal with it. We'll solve the next question now. The next question that I have is, a motorcycle is moving with a velocity of 90 km per hour and it takes 5 seconds to stop after the brakes are applied. Calculate the force exerted by the brakes on the motorcycle if its mass along with the rider is 200 kg. Now let's see what all I have. So now I have the velocity as 90 km per hour. Now whenever I'm asking anyone to solve these type of questions, I always say check the units. The units should be in standard unit. Now see, it's kilometer per hour. And it takes 5 seconds to stop after the brakes are applied. So this basically is my initial velocity. The final velocity is, let's say, 0 km per hour. And the time it takes to transfer to this is 5 seconds to take and calculate the force. So I need to find the force exerted by the brakes on the motorcycle if its mass along with the rider is 200 kg. Just, it's a very simple way to do these questions. Just keep on writing what all you have, what's there in the question, so that you know you do not commit any mistake in checking the question. Now you have done this, you need to find F. So I'll be using this equation again because I have U, V, T and N. Yes, so I can easily find force. So F is M V minus U divided by T. So M would be 200 divided by V is 0 minus U. So see, it's in seconds, it's in hour. I need to convert this hour into seconds. So either you can multiply it by, you know, 5 by 18, or what you can do is simple 90 times 1000 for kilometer to turn into meter, you need to multiply it by 1000, and for hour to convert to seconds, you need to divide by 3600. And thus you will have your seconds. Two zeros cancel, 10, 9, 4, it's 100 upon 4, which will be 25 meter per second. Very simple way. Meter per second, similarly this, anything divided or multiplied by 0 is 0, so this will be 0 meter per second, 5 seconds kg. Everything is sorted. For you, I will put 25 divided by, for time, I have 5. Now let's solve this. So it will be 200. 0 minus 25 will give me minus. So I have minus 25 divided by 5. 5 5s are 25. I'll deduct this. Minus in front, 5 2s are 10 and 2 zeros more. This, and I am finding force, so it's minus 1000 newton. Since there is a deceleration, obviously, so the force applied is coming to be negative. So you will say that the force exerted by the brakes on the motorcycle will be 1000 newton. I hope this is clear to you. Let's solve the next question now. Question 6. Now question 6. It says, what is the momentum of a man of mass 75 kg when he walks with a velocity of 2 meter per second? So it is saying that the mass of the man is 75 kg. He walks with a velocity of 2 meter per second. What is the momentum? Now momentum is mass times velocity, the units kg, units meter per second, it's fine. So mass will be 75 times velocity is 2. So the answer will be 150, and units of momentum is kg meter per second. That is your answer. Next question that I have is, what would be the force required to produce an acceleration of 2 meter per second square in a body of mass 12 kg? What would be the acceleration if the force were doubled? So there are two questions here. First, we'll solve the first part. So it says, what would be the force required to produce an acceleration of, so it's asking what is the force required to produce an acceleration of 2 meter per second square of a body of mass 12 kg. So the simple formula that we will use is F is equal to ma, m is 12, a is 2, so I'll get answer is 24, force is newton. Simple. This is my first case. The second case, it says, what will be the acceleration if the force were doubled? Now it's saying for the force to be doubled. So F equals ma is my original one. F2 is equal to, it says the mass will be same and I'll get a new acceleration. So I need to find A2. A2 is equal to, I'll put M down, so F2 divided by M. Now, in the question it is said that my F2 is twice of my F1, which is, F1 is obviously 24, yes? So, I'll say twice of F, so twice of 24, which will give me 48 Newton. I'll put the value of F2 here, 48 divided by the value of M is 12, and I will get 4, and acceleration is meter per second square. That is your solution. It's very easy. See, if you use the formula, a simple formula that I am using is F equals MA. It's not a big deal. You just should know how to proceed with the question. Write what is given to you, write what you need to find, write the formula that you have, and simple, just go on with it. Put in the values and you'll be done with the question. Next question we have is, a man pushes a box of mass 50 kg with a force of 80 Newton. What will be the acceleration of the box? So it says a man pushes a box of mass 50 kg with a force of 80 Newton. What will be the acceleration? It's easy, right? F is equal to ma. From there, a is equal to f divided by m, right? So a will be, f is how much? 80 divided by m is how much? 50. So I'll divide this, and because you know this is the final term, 0 will be cancelled out. So I'll get 1.6 meter per second square. Simple. Next part says that what would be the acceleration if the mass were doubled? Now, what would be the acceleration? A2 is F upon M2. Now this M2 is, mass is doubled. So my M2 is twice of M, which is twice of 50, which is 100 kg, right? So M2 will be 100, and the force that is applied, force is 80. So my final answer would be 0.8 meter per second square. I hope this is clear to you. There are a few other questions which we will be doing in our next class. I hope you are clear with this concept. I'll be putting in few questions in the link below, in the content below. You can have a look at it and you can solve them. I'll also try to put up the answers there so you can match your answers, or you can write your answers in the comment section and I'll give you a thumbs up for it. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Have a great weekend. Next, we will be doing the third law of the motion. Stay tuned. Stay connected. Bye.